23rd, 2018. Select Board meeting to order. Chair Hubert is unable to attend this evening. We wish her speedy recovery. We will continue on in her absence. First order of business is the approval of the April 16th minutes. I took a look at them and didn't see anything that needed to be changed, but...
I didn't either.
All right, so by consensus, we will, excuse me, approve the April 16th minutes. Community input. Yes?
Hi. I have the plan for the recording from the library trustees. And I'm actually at a library trustees meeting at the same time I'm visiting. I just left the library.
Okay.
Come here and then head back down. I can send this to electronically too, but I wanted to just let you know that we've approved this plan as a board and go over a few of the details or any questions that you might have. And find out what the next steps would be.
So, okay.
Can you electronic one too?
Yes.
Yeah, if you could send electronic, that will be helpful for...
We literally just finished it.
Salome and Suzanne.
Yeah.
Waving to the person who's not saying anything between us. Okay, so the basic proposal is that whatever board is meeting that evening, their secretary will record the meeting on a camera that's... Being donated by the library trustees, is that what I'm seeing? Okay. Okay, and then it would reside on a town-owned Vimeo channel. Basic is free.
So the library, what we're thinking is the library would do the annual subscription to Vimeo and maintain the channel for town recordings. So we would do the town, that way the town doesn't have to, as the board of selectmen change or other people that work here, it remains in the library's custody and is maintained there. And the reason that we thought that was a good idea is the other community that we were looking at that has done something similar, kind of taken over some aspects of, there was like a local paper, and they've kept it in the library for continuity purposes. And the people that are in the library have maintained the content consistently. So that's what we're thinking. And library would pay the annual fee for that, and if it needed to be upgraded to, so Vimeo has a free version, which has a certain amount of pages that you can load each month. They have this version, which is the lowest paid version that they have. With the paid version, you get support and you get analytics, so you can look at, you know, how many people watched and get some data from them every month for different things. You can kind of keep an eye on that, which is interesting. You don't have that with a free account. And it can always be upgraded. The next level is $12.99, $14. You know, you can, if you needed to have more space and more, whatever, you can always upgrade.
Is Vimeo one of those services that is ad-free?
Yes, it's completely ad-free. I use it for my business. Your page is completely free, not only ads, but any other videos. So YouTube, other videos run up on our side of the page.
Right.
Vimeo is only your, you can completely control all the content that's on it.
Okay. Do you have any questions?
And then the memory card piece, that would be, you know, Suzanne, that's what would be expensive for the town. What we thought is that the different secretaries, two of those boards actually are the same person, would manage the memory cards, but the memory cards would be the only thing that the town would be responsible for providing. So that cost for the year would be around $80, unless somebody lost a card or, you know, wasn't handled appropriately and we had to replace it. But that way, the secretaries are kind of in charge of the card, and the camera lives here, and the library is responsible for moving the data off the cards onto the Vimeo channel.
And where will it be here, when you say it's going to live here?
The camera?
Yeah.
So I would leave that to you to figure out how you wanted to manage that little piece. But I know there's some cabinets in here that lock, and maybe there's a place. I don't know.
It's just, if a select board person isn't here, then the office isn't available. So I didn't know how that works. How would that work?
I guess we would need to figure that out.
Okay.
If the vast majority of time people meet in here, then maybe there's a way to have it in here.
Yep, because if they maybe have one cabinet that the four of them would have, key to the same cabinet, then it shouldn't be an issue.
And I'm picturing that everybody gets a little, like, zipper bag that they can keep their figured as far as working out the details of the transfer, we would speak to whomever was, Mintzman, you, Corey, and Sarah are the current secretaries.
Who's the duplicated one?
Sarah does CBA.
Both of them?
CBA.
Oh, it's just Corey and...
Right, so obviously Sarah can bring her own in regards to the library, but we need to figure out like how we're gonna get them back.
Any other questions?
So there is a camera?
Yep.
And there is a tripod?
Yep.
Okay. And the $84 expense, is that the Friends of the Library, or is that gonna be a budgetary item on the library trustees?
The fee will be donated this year, and then going forward, it will become a line item in the library.
In the budget?
Yep.
Okay.
All right, we will take this plan, this proposal under advisement, and we will forward it on, if you can forward it on electronically.
Yeah, actually, what I'll do is, I will, I'll, in the body of the email, I'll also write Suzanne just those couple little details that we discussed as well, that everybody can kind of talk about there. What I'm curious to know is if we were gonna go ahead and do this, I do wanna be able to let everybody kind of know the next step. If you all vote on it and approve it, would we be able to get it going by next month?
I'm speaking for myself, yes.
Okay.
But, I mean, I don't, Suzanne knows about this anyway.
Yeah.
Just going over this, she's the one that asked for this, and...
Yeah, I think she's the one who wanted to see the plan, so I think we're not gonna take action on it tonight, so wait until she gets back.
Once she's seen it, you guys, okay, perfect.
Then we can decide.
I think she's gonna, the plan is for her to be here next week, so we should be able to take action.
Excellent.
One way or the other, next week, and...
Yeah.
Perfect. All right, thanks so much.
Thank you very much. Any other community input? All right, moving right along now, we don't have any department heads here at the moment, I think that will probably change. This department has something on the agenda for this evening, I can't, sorry, can't put them on all the way and look up. Town administration, post-meeting chores, we have, as a placeholder on here, committee appointments, the election of chairs, the zoning board of appeals, and the planning board are the two outstandings. ZBA should be handled in the beginning of May, and the planning board will be on May 8th, when they next meet. We will elect a chair that evening. Management, is there any questions? Management response, I suggest we table that, Suzanne's working on it. Transfer station stickers from one vehicle to the next, so I have practice versus ordinance. I read the ordinance today, it is silent. So I then went to what's been the practice, so I spoke with the town clerk, and she said that there's a $5 replacement for a sticker. If you can't scrape it off and put it, if they peel off, you can put them on another car. If you get a new car, a new windshield, I've had to do that unfortunately several times with passes, but for parking and everything else. So the question is, though, is it's been the practice, it's not in the ordinance, so I would suggest what we need to do, and this is one of the ordinances we can actually, we have the ability to change on our own, we don't have to go to town meeting. We were given that permission when the ordinance was enacted. So when I get back in May, we can put a new section, if we feel like we need to, we put a new section in that says replacement stickers are available at $5.
What is the permit sticker cost at the...
$10.
$10, okay. But there's a cost to the stickers, I mean, so that's probably why they were doing that.
And the administrative cost, so. Okay. And that will settle that for now anyway, so we will, we've discussed it, but I think we'll table until May, if that's okay with you, and I'll be off my place in the agenda. All right. C, quarter one budget report, we tabled, this was a suggestion of our road agent George Gomet, he wanted to discuss managerial duties at the transfer station. So I would suggest we table that until he returns, and let him speak to his plans, or his thoughts, rather. I don't want to put words in his mouth, so. Training and municipal budget process, scheduled for May 2nd, the select board, I won't be there, you and Suzanne are gonna be hosting my absence, with the budget committee and other town committees. Suzanne was hoping, she's not here this evening, was hoping to do some PR around it, much like the the free one that you'd signed up for.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Just basically saying what it is. She wants to be able to send that out before the next meeting. I don't have a problem with that. She's usually...
Well, she's just trying to get department heads as well to attend and anybody else who has interest in budget process, so...
Okay, so you're all managing that. I just want to make sure we're okay with... Okay. So we'll say, go ahead and put out your notice on the town website. Recreation, okay. Walmart grant, I think that's what it says, Dick's, I'm assuming that's what it says. Dick's Sporting Goods, see 423 emails. Okay, so we're going to deviate a little bit from the agenda. And why don't you come up here, Celia? I think you're the one that has information about this, right?
I am.
And we'll have you talk about it now. If that's okay with you?
That is fine. In the folder from Caroline should be a letter on town letterhead to Walmart. And that authorizes the rec committee to apply for a grant. And says that you guys you are the authorizing agent. And the rec committee would, of course, submit anything to the select board at the same time we submitted to them. We'd get an email.
Right. So by applying for the Walmart grants and any of the other ones, are we requiring the town of Rollinsford to do anything in particular, or put any money forward, matching funds forward?
Not as far as I know.
Okay.
We're going for the community grant program, and I've highlighted it here. It's $250 to $5,000 from the corporate office. If we were going to the local store, it would be $250 or less. And it says, organizations must operate on a local level and directly benefit the service area of this facility for which they are requesting funds from. So that's what that is.
All right, so my next question to you then, before we get too much further into this, let me pull up the budget. The question is, do you have revenue as part of your budget?
Or
offsetting grants or something.
We put in grants and scholarships between $3,000 and $5,000. It does not break down there. I looked at it earlier.
Okay.
And
in here somewhere though that's broken down, doesn't it?
I don't know. The person that I spoke to that created the budget was Deanie Hawk and Jody.
Yep.
Lloyd Farms.
Right.
And I requested that they put in a couple.
Jody had it for us when we put this together. Maybe we didn't.
And
maybe it was for the auditor. Maybe it wasn't for the book. So.
Yeah, I think it's part of the town side. I don't think they have their own in the book.
So they did put in some money for grants, and they did put in some contingency money on the outgoing side, so that if we brought in more funds than so there is money coming in for grants, and there is a contingency line too, so that money could go in and out. That's what I'm saying.
All right.
And I could look it up and get it to you guys. The Walmart grant is not as pressing as some of the other ones. It is on the drive too, under the committee.
It's on the share drive under
yes.
Rec.
It should be.
Yeah. She sent a phone, or did you send it just to me because I'm on the rec committee? Was he on copy? Because I got it through my select board. Email.
The
did you send it to the board of selectmen?
Today I did.
Then you can go and see the documents attached to that.
Yeah. Depending on when you sent it, I wasn't on email. So, yeah.
So this is the community grant guidelines that say our application will remain active for 90 days. We can submit up to 25 applications. It talks about it can be a recognized government entity That's why we have to have the letter, because it shows that we're a recognized government entity. And out of the 8 funding sources, the 3 that we would qualify would be quality of life, improving access to recreation or cultural or arts experience for low-income individuals and families, community and economic development, which is improving local communities for the benefit of low-income families and individuals. And we are already have 3 scholarships available to help that. And then we also qualify for the diversity and inclusion, which is fostering the building of relationships and understanding among diverse groups.
Okay.
So
your percentage of children that fall into that category is very low.
Very low.
Your majority of your money coming in is from average or above house income, right?
That's what I'm beginning to understand.
Wouldn't you have to prove that you qualify for those?
I don't. It didn't say that. It said there are 8 areas which an organization can apply. Please review these below to ensure your organization's goals falls within one of these. So if it doesn't fall into the first 2, the 3rd one is building relationships and understanding diversities of different groups.
And what are you doing to do that? I mean, if I understand this correctly, this is something you have to do to work on that, right?
It's
I have a program that's going to be part of that. That's what they're going to sponsor, is a program that will help you do that. You
right.
know, have that in your agenda.
We do in a couple different ways. It's one of the goals of the rec department to keep our tuitions as low as possible, so that we can incorporate more people and provide the local community with recreational and arts activities. So we will bring in different activities.
I know, that's not diversity. Right?
I don't know how Walmart defines it, but in my mind it isn't. But so my concern is that I don't have a problem. If Walmart wants to give us money and they think we're doing that, I don't have a problem with that. As long as it's going to offset what it's going to cost the taxpayers to run the program. My concern is, and I think what Denise is getting at, and I don't put words in your mouth, but as long as we're not on the hook for being able to prove that we are actually working towards any of these things, because you don't have it as part of your program.
Well, I think I think you're going to have to prove that you're doing these.
Okay.
And I don't think you're improving the diversity. Sorry, I hear fire engines, and I just...
They're coming this way.
Right?
Yeah, coming this way.
You're not fostering and building relations and understanding diverse groups of the United States. It's not part of your program, right? So I think you have to prove that it's part of your program. Any grant that I've ever applied for, you have to prove that. The amount of low-income individuals and families, it's a really small percentage of your whole picture. So again, I think you have to prove how much that is going to be part of your program. I just think you have to do a little more research. That is my point.
So okay. So we don't need an action tonight, right?
Not on that one, no.
Okay.
Oh,
well,
okay.
I think on. I'm just going to put this out here right now. Suzanne's going to want to look at all of these.
Yeah.
She is. Now I apologize. She couldn't be here tonight. She wasn't going to be here anyway because she was going to be on vacation, but that didn't happen for her. So. But she's going to want to take a look at these. So, and I want to honor that request of hers. Because I know she's the one who's been talking to you about this previously. I mean, as long as we're not on the hook for anything, I don't have a problem signing them. But, again, I think that in fairness to Sudan, we need to wait. That's okay with you?
I'm just saying, for me to sign something, you have to prove to me that you are meeting that goal in which you're applying for. And I don't really think that at least 2 of them, you're not.
Okay.
Unless you know more than I do about your diversity in this town or the low income part of it, because you offer scholarships for low income. I don't know if you use them all or how that works, but there isn't a lot of that. Mostly it's families paying for it.
What are the other options?
So this one. one is Optimal Bank and Trust, they just wanted to.
Oh, no, sorry, let me just say this too. Thank you for taking the initiative to look for these.
Oh, absolutely.
She would have said that from the outset, so we do appreciate that, we're not trying not to rain on your parade here, so. So for Walmart, what were the other options?
Hunger relief and healthy eating, which we don't provide a meal for, so that's out.
Right.
Health and Human Services, providing medical screening, social services, or shelter. We don't provide that. Education, providing after-school enrichment, tutoring, or vocational training for low-income families, and which we wouldn't provide.
Right.
Do you think that you would be better off to go to the local Walmart versus the nationwide one?
Or do they have the same requirements?
Well, it may just be giving $250 and then you can use that money for sports equipment or whatever you choose to. For this time, since you're kind of getting short on time, I think you might be better off doing it local.
We might be, but we would still need the letter. They asked for the letter last year, and we didn't go through the proper channels to get the letter with their wording or their format.
Right.
The letter would still have to go to the local Walmart, and they still require several weeks before. So we could try the local Walmart. And getting back to Mike's question, the other two categories were public safety, supporting public safety programs through training or equipment in the United States, or environmental sustainability, preventing waste, increasing recycling, or supporting other programs.
So we're not really making the mark on any of those.
So I will continue to look and see, because the other thing that comes to my mind is that we have been approached in the past about bringing in different groups or different individuals. There was a gentleman who forwarded us information last year that we weren't able to afford. That would be $500 or $600 for the day to come in and talk about bullying and different cultures.
Right.
Well, that might be, that might be, if you're putting that as a program and that's what you're actually aiming for, that might be better off than saying, in general, we're going to do something about it ourselves, but we need funds to do it.
That would make
sense. If you're actually bringing a guest speaker or someone who does it with fun activities and stuff, that's probably where you should aim it, but you'd have to, in order for me to sign it, you would have to have that on the application for me to say okay.
Okay, and so I did not go any further in looking at the Walmart application because it's all online.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to get your perspective on the letter before I went forward. And the other thing is, it's like we've looked at bringing in different groups, and it might fit into the environmental sustainability, is like bringing in wildlife groups like the Center for Wildlife out of York, or the Mount Washington Observatory that brings programs into schools, bring them down for a day.
Yeah.
And those programs we could potentially fund with these dollars.
But I was saying, and again, though, putting that on your application, that's your plan to use these funds, you're going to be better off getting the money than you would be just asking for a grant and saying it's for this, it falls in this category. You got to tell them what you want it for, or what it's aiming for.
Before I went any further, I wanted to see if the select board was willing to look at this.
Sure. What are the other ones we got there?
So this is Dick's Sporting Goods, and it is very hard to read. So we are asking them to, this is what we're asking Dick's to, I don't know if I'm going to be hard, to help provide sporting equipment and stuff for the kids to play with. And we have to provide them a copy of our sponsorship letter. So that's what that is. And then,
that's for equipment, for tennis rackets and
volleyballs.
So we're asking them first to help us by donating $250. And then the second option would be to provide equipment
directly if they put.
And then the third option would be to provide a gift card
to
go and buy it.
And so those are.
And do you need a letter from us for that?
Nope. I just need to make sure that you guys know that that is what.
I think that's a good one.
Do you have any objection to that one?
Nope.
I don't either. And we're not required to
sign in.
Sign. We're not required to do any match or anything like that.
Not as far as I can tell.
We can't match it though because we don't have the funds.
Right, you don't have the money to match it, that's why we're, we wanted to make sure.
This was actually brought to the rec committee by another committee member who spoke to other organizations like Marshwood Youth Baseball, the local cross companies and stuff. They all work with Picks, and Picks has given them like $200 to put towards their online registration fees.
I don't have, as long as there's no cost to the town, I don't have any issue with that at all. Go forth and ask Picks Sporting Goods for $400.
Okay, then I have Optima Bank, which I completed today, and I have not submitted, but their deadline's the end of May, so that is that one. And you guys can look it over, and that would get us our money June 15th. They take a 2-week grace period to use the money for July and August. So it would be a week lapse between the start of camp and when the funds would be available.
So when you, if and when you get any grants, are you required to send them some kind of a statement saying, this is how much I received, this is what I spent it on, and this, and then the balance is zero? Are you required to do that?
For some of them, we are, and I have sent out. I know like last year when we did the REF one, we did have the person who ran the program write up a letter.
Mm-hmm. That was our requirement though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I have a thank you card that we created last year, and it's got the Camp Raleigh like Lego figure on the front and stuff. I've asked our graphic designer who worked with us to help us update it and put like the teen camp on it. So I will be writing out thank you letters. I have not done it yet because the registration or the donation period, sponsorship period is still open until June 1st, but they will be getting letters.
Okay.
Thank you.
The only thing what I'm asking this question for is because at the end of the year, any money left over goes to the town's revenue source. It doesn't roll over. So I want to just make sure if you receive funds from a grant that those funds are definitely going to what you're saying they're going, not coming out of the other resources that you have, so then it's gone. It's nothing's left over. Do you understand? Do you see what I'm saying? So it doesn't go to the end of the year Rollins with town revenue. Okay?
So you're asking if these funds are going to be used first for a designated purpose versus
the
general fund money?
For the designated purpose that you're telling these organizations that you're using it for. So if Bob's Sporting Goods gives you a $100 gift card, you go out and you buy the sporting goods stuff,
yes.
Okay? And then it's done, it's gone, it's moved on. And then you send them and say, this is what we did with your grant. If, you know, if Optima gives you money and whatever you're choosing, if it's, you're having someone come and it covers what their donation was, you send them a letter saying, this is what we did and this is how the money was spent. So it doesn't
linger.
You don't know who's in this town or whoever works wherever they work, and then they see that it goes in the bottom line. And we want to make sure that they know that the money that you receive from these organizations go to what you say they're going to go to.
And that has been our practice, but we don't necessarily have a policy for that.
Yeah.
Like last year, we got a big grant from C&J, and it went to cover all of the T-shirts.
Right. Right.
And then they requested photographs and stuff of the kids in their T-shirts out on field trips.
Because they can promote that on their website that they sponsored this.
Right.
That's all I'm saying is that, you know, maybe take a picture of all the sport gear you bought and then send it and say thank you. Have the kids wave and thanking, whatever. I'm just saying make sure that they know what you spent it on. Even if they don't require it, you can send them a follow-up letter saying this is what we did, thank you for your support, and this is what we did with that money. And make it enough so you know that, you know, that's why you, on the two of them, you need to have
Optimus
a purpose.
Okay,
Optimus,
as far as I look at it, looks fine.
Okay,
there's no obligation, so.
I am working on one more that is time sensitive, but I made a mistake in it, so I will bring it back next week.
Perfect.
But it is for Eastern Bank, and it's a $500 grant, and I put the committee chair instead of the select board as the executives.
Okay, so we'll take it up next week then, perfect. Thank you very much.
Again, is it just a general roundabout money or is it for a certain purpose?
There, they have other grants that are for certain purposes. I believe this one is a general grant, but I continue to work on it and I will specify.
Okay.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next two are Suzanne, so we're gonna table unless you have anything, any objection you wanna talk about. Hi, Sam, I'm gonna get to them right now. Just wanna table these before I forget.
Yep.
Chief, come on up.
Thank you.
More than welcome. We're moving right along tonight, so it's the perfect time.
What's wrong with the firehouse?
What's wrong with the firehouse?
What's wrong with the firehouse?
Nothing, huh?
Oh, we just heard several fire trucks.
Yeah, okay. Maybe they're gonna stop.
Well, I heard there's a fire alarm activation someplace, but I don't know.
Okay.
I have two purchase orders. The first one is to Police One Academy, purchase order number 1373. And it's our annual membership, annual training program that we have with the Police One. And that's $984, and that will come out of Pro Development. That's an annual expense.
You move it now, second.
Okay, I move purchase order 1373 for Police One Academy for 12 annual training subscriptions for $984 for Pro Development.
Second. Any discussion? Coming out of the Pro Development line, so. Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, those opposed, and it's approved. Sam wants to see it, so for the notes.
Purchase order number 1374, made out to Seacoast Business Machines in Barrington. And this is for the annual service contract for our copier fax machine. And that will come out of line 9201, our office expense, and that's $620.50.
Can I ask a question?
Move it.
Well, move it first. 1374 for Seacoast Business Machines, one annual service contract for the copier. For $620.50.
Second.
All right. So my question is, does the town and the police use the same small business machine company?
That's what we do, yes. The town just recently purchased a machine for upstairs here from the same company.
Same company? Okay. Yeah. Very good. But they have contracts on different ones, though.
But, right. They have their own service contract.
Okay. Right. But because we, I think, went with the same company that we already have a contract with downstairs, then we got a better price because they're coming here.
I was hoping that you would say.
Yeah. You guys
get
the better deal.
We, well, sorry,
I know,
but you know.
The town,
we appreciate your longevity with that because we all made out, I guess, in the end. So. All right, any other questions? If not, I'll call the question on purchase order number 1374. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed? All right. You have a non-public one that I said?
I do.
See?
Okay.
Do you want
to just do this one first? Our planning board meeting key doesn't work.
Have we, that was on the agenda to talk about too. We can do that before we go on non-public. Have we rekeyed upstairs? Are we?
Yes, you're all rekeyed upstairs.
Okay. Yeah. So we need to, we haven't officially said whether we're not going to do it or not, but we've had a request from the chairman of cemetery trustees. He'd like a key so he can get into his office down the hall to get to his files.
Which seems it
is the same room as the planning board. So anyway,
Mark Kutcher.
To me, it makes sense. I mean, I'm only one member of the board, but for him to be able to get in there, I don't think that he needs access to the whole building, but I mean, he needs access to his files, of course, in the front door.
Yeah.
Same for the chair of the planning board, which we don't have one yet. It's currently Miles England. I don't know that he's not going to get re-elected, but that won't be until May 8th. But I don't think there's... We need another copy, obviously, so we can keep it in our office, but...
Yeah, what was the process of when you were doing the rekeying to kind of eliminate? Are you giving them to chairs of committees and...
That's the plan, yes.
Okay.
I'll give them to the chairs of committees.
Okay, so the budget committee chair...
Right, the budget committee chair...
Is John Ordway.
And anybody else.
John Ordway.
John Ordway is the chair.
Yeah, yeah. We said we didn't know because everything got rekeyed and we didn't know what it was going to go, but... I can send him to see you.
So in the past, Bill Irving had been letting the budget committee, so we had his old key back.
Yeah, he told us that, yeah. So I said, I didn't know if you were going to be able to get one because I didn't know what the plan was for
sure.
additional key, but I told him you were the key keeper.
They'll get the key for the door, plus they'll get a pass card number. They won't get the card like you have to get the office, but they'll get a number. They'll disengage and engage the alarm system.
Oh, the alarm system, but not to get in any other office.
They'll go get in the office.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
I'm good with that. Awesome. So you want to go to non-public now, or?
Yes, if you would, please.
Well, I'll move that we go into non-public session for the purposes of dealing with a personnel issue.
Second.
We'll do roll call.
Yes.
Denise, yes. Mike, yes. We're not, anything else, chief?
I will say, I'm ready.
I don't think so.
We're true.
Thank you very much. Have a great night. All right. Any other department heads here? Don't see you. I want to pass over them. Conservation funds. I think this is something Suzanne wanted to talk about. Unless you know something about it, but I don't know about it.
Well, did you get the email that said that the funds have always been in the safe?
Oh, that's what it was, that's all it's about?
Continuously in the safe. I think that might have been why.
We were wondering where the checkbook had gone off to. It's where it's always has been.
And it should always stay, yes.
It should stay. So, I mean, so we could take that off then, for, we've covered that. Okay. Initial conversation, meeting twice monthly, that's Suzanne's, item, we'll table that then. And Oak Street boundary preambulation, MOU winter versus comprehensive. I can speak to the preambulation, hasn't happened yet, it's not gonna happen until May. Although it's warm enough certainly today to do it, but I wasn't available. And the MOU, I believe, I can't think of his name now, the attorney for Dover, he's with these blankets, I don't know what he's done, was working with our attorney. They were gonna take the lead, and it was their idea, because they have a staff that's on salary, and we don't. So they were gonna handle that and present something to us, which we have not received yet. So we will table that, unless there's anything else to say about it. Town administration, board standing activities, or updates. Denise?
Well, I went to the budget meeting last week, and John Ordway is the chair, and Bill Irving is vice chair of the budget committee, and that's all I've done.
All right, the historical committee had their walk yesterday of the village. There was about 50 people that came. Another very well-attended event, it was awesome. That was very exciting. There were, as I left, I actually saw them yesterday afternoon too, but this morning there were, I think it's no exaggeration, say dozens of those blue bags on the side of the road.
I know.
Kudos to the volunteers that did that. Cleaned up the town, and when I saw the DOT trucks actually picking them up, so I thought, road agent's on vacation this week, who's going to pick up these bags?
Well, Highway sent it, put something on Facebook that said they would be picking him up today.
No, on town road, but on the state road. They came through on the state road.
Yeah.
I thought that was great.
Yeah.
So it was, obviously it was Earth Day, so they know that the towns are doing it.
That something's going to happen,
yep. So I thought that was wonderful. So the state picked those up on the state road. Other board activities, on May 8th, I'll just say it again, the planning board is meeting. The only thing on the agenda at the moment is the election of the chair, and then to go over for the year, start to discuss ordinance changes that may need updates. It's a yearly thing that we do, taking a look at things that need to change. Given the training that we had a few months ago, there were some suggestions, and some very good suggestions that were made by Attorney Radigan, that procedures that we don't necessarily have in place, that we should, for our own safety as a community, protection. So I think we'll be discussing those. So, like say, if you get a subdivision approved, and you don't do anything with it for years, well, there's X amount of time. If you don't have so much invested, it's called vesting. If you don't have money invested into for a road or anything, then we're out of luck and you're starting over again. And we don't do that, and we probably should be, because there are a number of, there's a one on Rollins Road for sale, a house that has an approved subdivision that happened decades ago and never happened. So should that still be legal? But so the planning board's going to discuss things like that. We won't be taking action, we'll just be discussing. And that's all I have. So we have building permits. We have several for this evening. The first thing that we have, where'd it go? Did I get it already?
What?
Before I forget, we'll do that first. We have a sewage. You get your stamp.
Nice.
So you'll need to stamp in this box here. instead of sign on. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sign and date, please.
Me?
Yeah.
Or you?
No, you. I wouldn't make you stamp and then sign. I would have done it myself.
Right here? Why am I signing this? What am I signing?
That acknowledging that we're in receipt of it.
Oh, that's all
and
it is.
It's been reviewed. It's been reviewed by Mr. Clark. He's got his note on there, so. We're acknowledging that we've received and reviewed the.
That's all I'm acknowledging.
And you've got a date, too. It didn't come through on the stamp.
What is it?
The 23rd.
4/23. 4/23/18.
Yep.
Okay.
And just make sure I didn't miss one somewhere.
So the looking on the quorum poll does this.
What's the address?
It is 589 Silver Street. The last name is Cormier. So, you know what, just to be safe, maybe stamp the plans anywhere on there, just sign it, just to be safe. There used to be a spot on there that, the state switched to just this cover sheet several years ago. Some folks, some planners or developers, septic designers, how good is that, eventually want to see it on the plans. It's now on there, so they should be good with.
So I'm not approving it, I'm just saying I've received it.
Mr. Clark has.
Mr. Clark has, all right, what are we gonna do with it?
Put it back in my folder.
All right.
Okay, first per, every time. First building permit of the evening is 2018-028, 620 Rollins Road. This is electrical permit on existing structure, an existing building permit for work. Fee is $125 and it has been reviewed by Mr. Clark.
Is there, can I ask a question?
Of course.
Is there something that's printed that tells you what you have to pay for building permit and don't have to pay for building permit?
Yes, it's in the zoning ordinance.
Okay. What you do and do not have to.
So, well.
What you do.
It doesn't, it's not as clear cut as that. It's not an exhaustive list. It says anything that adds $1,500 or more value to your property.
But do you have to want a replacement of?
Yeah, so like if you were replacing your front porch.
Yeah.
You would have to. If you're replacing your front door and an overhang and stuff like that, yeah.
Really?
It adds $1,500 of new value to your property. Because if you had an old sagging porch, right?
Okay.
And they came to do the assessment, they'd say, well, it's a nice house, but we take off X amount because it's got a sagging porch or your garage has fallen off or.
But if you have broken boards and you're just replacing the broken boards, you don't have to.
No.
But if you're replacing the whole thing and putting on.
It can be a judgment call. I mean, if it's not, but if you're putting up a fence, you don't need a building permit for a fence.
Now,
there are requirements of how you have to put your fence up, but you don't have to build. But if you were building a giant stone mortar fence around there, I don't know. I mean, that's sort of a gray area, I would say. But we've always said that we don't require a building permit. But if you're putting up a shed, you need one.
Or if you buy a shed already made, you need one.
Still need one. Because you're adding $1,500 or more
property
value.
Even though it's removable.
So let's just say, for the sake of argument, the building materials only cost $1,000. It doesn't matter. And that's where people sort of get hung up. Because it says clearly it's $1,500 worth of value to your property. You know, you can do the work yourself. People re-roof their all the time. But you still have to pay for it. Because the value you're adding is not
the value
cost
of what you cost.
Right.
Okay.
So some people, and I get that, it can be confusing. People don't do this for their living. They don't know. But, so that's why we try to help people, guide them through the process. The next one is 2018-029, 23 Rollins Road. Putting in a carport and driveway. It has been approved by Mr. Clark, so it meets the setbacks. They received a notice of variance from the zoning board back in 2017, December, but it's now finally nice enough for them to do the work. Poor folks, they could have used that car for, I'm sure, all winter. So it's been thoroughly vetted. So fee is $185.
final one that I have is 2018-030. It is 410-412 2nd Street. House across from me. They are putting on a new roof, our part roof. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. It is a $135 fee. Signing them there.
Okay.
If it was just one of us signing it, then yes, we'd have to take a vote. But we're majority of the board signed it. So it's also a traceable public action. Okay. So there's a file that anyone come and look at if they want. And that's all I have.
Okay.
Do you need anything, Sally?
Okay. Correspondences. Greater Somerset Chamber of Commerce. I guess it's notifying us of the 2018 Annual Dinner and Awards, Spring Hill and South Park. We're part of this Somerset Chamber of Commerce.
We don't pay dues, but I guess the businesses can belong. I thought we belonged to the Dover ones too.
Oh, okay.
When I say belong, the businesses can belong, we don't belong. But.
Okay. So that's just telling us about it, I guess.
We have any of our businesses being honored? May 11th.
Okay, this is, I think this was in there before. This is the Avatar Associates of New England about an abatement for Eversource.
Yep. Is there an update on it? Okay, we were telling them to contact them.
And found no difference than the ones filed in the past. Oh, they found.
Oh, they're denying.
Associates. Okay, so they found no different. Found if no different than the ones filed in the past, they claim a flaw in my approach as I don't consider the income or sales approach to value on public utilities, and therefore my results are inconclusive.
So every year, Eversource and whatever that phone company is called now, mm-hmm. I don't know what they're not Fairpoint anymore, they got bought out again. Whoever they are now.
Consolidated.
Sure.
Yeah.
Is that what they're called now? They object to abatements, or rather assessments in every town that does assessments on utilities. Mm-hmm. They'll fight it through the tax and the Board of Tax and Land Court, Appeals Court. They'll lose there or win there. If they lose, then they appeal to the Superior Court eventually. We've been involved in involved in multiple lawsuits with both companies.
Okay. So they're saying.
In less of a class action.
Right.
Dozens of other towns. I mean, you know, it's not like we're on our own.
So it says they once again recommend denial of their right. Of this abatement.
And I would
so
say we
I'm
should probably go along with them, but personally, we should file it.
Yeah.
So awesome. Xfinity was
right. Oh, it's just a new deal design. That's nothing. This is back in March. We had to talk about this.
Is that it?
Yep. I'm
awesome.
Asking them to take this old stuff out and file it somewhere.
Awesome. Perfect.
Okay. And use this stuff that is, that's the annual post-closure, but we still have
to deal with George,
George when
back.
He gets back.
And then when I get back. So
yep.
No worries.
Yep.
There was one thing I forgot. I signed the check. I need you to sign. I already signed it. The check manifest.
Oh.
So for the town treasurer to sign the checks that we
okay, general information on building permits. You don't need one for a metal fence, but you do for a wooden fence. You need a building permit.
We, I'll go back and look at the ordinance, but we have not, I say we, this board hasn't taken it up yet, but we haven't had
I'm not trying to blame Ed, he's just the one who taught this to me. He said we never did it for fences.
Oh, okay.
So we could, I mean, it could be part of the ordinance, Carl, I go back and look at it.
Maybe I'm wrong.
We don't have, we haven't had anyone come to us for a wooden fence, they've all been chain linked, to be honest with you, so. But it could very well, you could be right, we go back and look at it again. Anything else? Yes.
And on the budget training on May 2nd.
Yep.
I thought that date was looking to be changed because of the number of people that can't make it.
No, we decided that, we had the majority and we decided to pursue it.
It was never voted on.
I'm sorry?
It was never voted on.
Doesn't have to be.
It's just that there's four of us that won't make it.
That's right.
So, let me just understand, so there's, what, 10 members of the budget committee, right?
There's 12.
12.
Lost two people somewhere. So 12 members, my apologies. Four people can't make it, eight can make it. The select board is hosting a training.
Yeah, we're hosting a training, but it's not just for budget committee, it's also the department heads.
Right, so.
And for the public, and who knows?
So it's not a requirement that day.
There's gonna be four others that can't make it another day. Decided to go forward with it. The two members that are new can make it.
Okay.
And the only one we don't know, because Mr. Jansen hasn't replied to John yet about acceptance.
Okay.
So we don't know if he's gonna make it.
Okay.
And we're gonna see if we can get someone to videotape it, because then Emily Leach would said that she would watch it on videotape and.
She's one of the ones that can't make it.
No, they're having the meet and greet for the principal, new principal at the school. So she's the school representative.
Gotcha.
So we decided to go with it.
I guess.
I think it would be gratefully appreciated if somebody would tape it.
We'll see what we can do.
I think that's the plan, that it should be taped.
That's the plan.
But I'd like to watch it too.
We have to make sure that we can get somebody.
Okay.
I'll talk to Tam.
Okay, any other community input? Seeing none, by consensus, we're going to go home at 7:30.